Hello guys, welcome back to DroidCrunch, and in this video we are going to see how you can use Dynamic.ooo visibility feature to hide or show any content for the user roles in your website. So for example, you can hide any content if the user is administrator, an editor, author, probably a subscriber or a guest. So all these user roles, there are many out there, so you can use any user role to hide the content or show the content, so based on the visibility settings you have. So let's look at what are the settings you have. So these features are available in Dynamic Visibility free version as well, so you can use that plugin. And some of the things are restricted if you are using visibility free version. This My Fast app is not available, or this custom condition is not available in free version. So if you want to use them, you will need to buy the pro version or the paid version of Dynamic.ooo. So make sure you have that version to use these two. Otherwise you can use this user and role, which we are going to use this time. So make sure you have enabled this visibility. This keep HTML is to hide the section based on the element CSS. Okay, and this is useful when you are using events trigger. And this one is to hide the content without using any condition, right? So it will always be hidden. And this is like using all these, you have responsive feature. This is same like this one, right? That one. So we don't want to use this one. And this is display mode to show or hide the content based on the conditions, right? So we want to show the content when the user role is an administrator, contributor, anything, but we will be going with administrator this time. Okay, so we are going to hide this section when the user is administrator. Sorry, show this section when this is a widget. We are on the widget, so we are going to show this widget when the user role is an administrator, right? So let's update this. So this form will be shown only when the user is an administrator. Perfect. So let me show you this one out. So I'm logged in, and let me just open this page, and I can see this, right, this form out here. But when I'm logged in from a guest, I can not see this form that I had, right? So it's working perfect. And you can also make it dynamic for any specific user by inputting its email, username, or the user ID, right? So you can make use of these parameters to perform all these visibility settings for the custom or the specific user role. And you can also specify the capability of the user, specify from all these capabilities, and you can find these capabilities options in the documentation of roles and capabilities under WordPress articles, right? And you can use them right here, like manage options. This is one of the capability. Okay, and then you have option for user field. So in user database you have multiple user meta fields, so you can specify like display name, probably is one of the user meta field. And we can specify if the display name, if it is less than or greater than, we can contain, make it like in array. Let's use equal to. So if the user field value is equal to this one, right, location. So if display name is location, only then show the content, right? And we can remove this one out here, otherwise it will follow this logical connective, because if we are using more than two conditions, then OR will be used when the condition will be satisfied, if any one of the condition is satisfied, right? So sure hide will work if any of the condition set is true, right? Otherwise, if you keep it to end, then all the conditions that you specify in various triggers out there will need to be satisfied for the visibility to perform, right? So this is by default or. So if any of the condition is specified, the visibility will work. So if I'm using administrator and this altogether, then if this administrator worked, then it the use of this will not be valid much. So we cannot actually see the action well. So we can remove this one out and then we can check this out. So it will be shown only when the display name is Lokesh, right? So let's reload. Perfect. We cannot see this because the display's name is not Lokesh, right? But it's style.wp. So we can say style my WP. Is it the right one? Let's update this. Okay, it came back because display name is true this time. So this is how we can use this one, right? We don't need to use this one for now. Click the image behind it. Okay, so we were on the user in role and this time let's use condition on this complete section and use user in role show and then user in role and then remote IP. So remote IP, you can specify the IPs like these, this example you can specify, and the content will be shown to the specific IPs or will be hidden for the specific IDs if you use display mode hide. And this way you can specify the custom IPs, like if you don't want them to show your content, then you can perform that in user role by inputting the IPs. And then there is a refer feature which works perfectly well if you can, if you want your users to come out from a different domain like external domains, then you can specify the external domain and enable this refer. And if the user is coming from this external domain, then only the page will be shown or the section or column, anything wherever the visibility is activated will be shown or hidden, right? So you can also make use of internal domains right here, but if it is empty, then the trigger will be like it will be performed every time. So only selected referrals once per line. If empty, it is triggered for all the external sites, right? So even if it's amazon.com coming from Amazon or any other site, even then the section will be shown or hidden based on the refer. So make sure you specify the domain. Like if you are running an advertisement on Facebook and you want that if someone is coming from Facebook, you should show a specific section like by greeting them something, so that they may connect more with your content. So that in that case you can use facebook.com and then enable this refer and show the content visibility. So you can make section for your Facebook users coming from Facebook users. The same way you can, if you have two domains and you want to make sure that if someone comes from this domain, then this specific section should be shown. And in that case, you can also use this feature called refer. And then here you can also specify the max per user count. And this would be working perfectly well. And you can also retrieve this data from dynamic tags as well. And this is how you can enable the user visibility under dynamic visibility of dynamic.ooo. And I hope this was very helpful for you. And if you have any questions, you can put down your comments and let me know your questions and I will be able to reply you right there. And if possible, I will be able to create the tutorial video on that specific question. And if you have any tutorial for me, you can also suggest me that too. And please subscribe to DroidCrunch so you can also watch more videos like this, and hit the bell icon so you don't miss the new videos that will be uploaded on this channel. And till then, bye bye and have a wonderful day.